20 foods that boost immune system. Why immune system is so important? The immune system protects us from disease caused by bacteria, viruses and toxins, and helps remove foreign bodies and malignant cells from our system. When your immune system is in tip-top condition, you probably don't even notice it working away to protect you around the clock. Instead of taking expensive supplement, there are certain foods may be helpful for boosting the immune system. Daily foods that boost your immune system naturally. 1. Garlic. For thousands of years, people all over the world have hailed garlic as an elixir of health. Its cloves are said to help treat the common cold, keep the plague at bay, and even ward off vampires. Despite its notorious odor, this veggie is the bulb of a plant in the sweet-smelling lily family. Ancient writings show that garlic was used as an aphrodisiac in India and as currency in Egypt. Today, at just 4 calories per clove, it's a low-cal immunity-boosting superstar. One clove contains 5 mg of calcium, 12 mg of potassium, and more than 100 sulfuric compounds, which are powerful enough to wipe out bacteria and infection. Interestingly, the group of participants taking a placebo had more than double the number of colds between them than those taking the garlic supplements. Let's take a look at some garlic recipes. Garlic knots on pizza and sandwiches. Herby pasta with garlic and green olives. Roasted garlic. Garlic baked potato. Yummy. While enjoying the benefits of garlic, we shouldn't overdose garlic because it may cause body odor or gas. 2. Blueberries. These humble little fruits are also immune-boosting superfoods. Blueberries contain flavonoids, a type of antioxidant that can help reduce damage to cells and boost your immune system. Antioxidants protect your body from free radicals, which are unstable molecules that can damage your cells and contribute to aging and diseases, such as cancer. Believe it or not, blueberries are believed to have one of the highest antioxidant levels of all common fruits and vegetables. In addition, blueberries have plenty of vitamins, including vitamin C, vitamin A, potassium, dietary fiber, and manganese. They are also about 85% water, and an entire cup contains only 84 calories, with 15 grams of carbohydrates. Aside from boosting immune system, blueberry can also help with digestion, improve skin conditions, promote healthy bones and boost brain functioning. The recipes include blueberry cheesecake, blueberry cream cheese cookies, blueberry buckle. However, we can't eat too much blueberry as it might boost blood sugar level. Fortunately, blueberry fruit is likely safe for most people when consumed in the amounts found in food. 3. Broccoli. Your parents knew what was up when they told you to eat your broccoli. This verdant vegetable is a powerhouse of nutrients. It's reputed to benefit digestion, the cardiovascular system and the immune system, and to have anti-inflammatory and even cancer-preventing properties. Plus, broccoli is low in sodium and calories, at about 31 calories per serving. It's also a fat-free vegetable. Broccoli has an impressive nutritional profile. It is high in fiber, very high in vitamin C and has potassium, B6 and vitamin A. Broccoli is also packed with phytochemicals and antioxidants. Phytochemicals are chemicals in plants that are responsible for color, smell and flavor. Research shows that they have numerous healthful benefits, according to the American Institute for Cancer Research. Phytochemicals in broccoli are good for the immune system. They include glucobrasicin, carotenoids, such as zeaxanthin and beta-carotene, and camphorol, a flavonoid. Caramelized broccoli with garlic. In a large, deep skillet, heat 2 tablespoons of the olive oil. Add the broccoli, cut side down, cover and cook over moderate heat until richly browned on the bottom, about 8 minutes. Add the water, cover and cook until the broccoli is just tender and the water has evaporated, about 7 minutes. Add the remaining 1 tablespoon of olive oil along with the garlic and the crushed red pepper and cook uncovered until the garlic is golden brown, about 3 minutes. Season the broccoli with salt and black pepper, drizzle with the lemon juice and serve. Roasted broccoli. Roasting makes broccoli as irresistible as French fries. This is our favorite way to cook it if you have the time. Oven-roasted broccoli comes out perfectly tender and charred, with crispy dark brown parts. It has a mild, almost sweet flavor. Stir in a little grated garlic, olive oil and lemon juice after roasting to make the flavor pop. In general, broccoli is safe to eat, and any side effects are not serious. The most common side effect is gas or bowel irritation, caused by broccoli's high amounts of fiber. All cruciferous vegetables can make you gassy, but the health benefits outweigh the discomfort. 4. Sweet potatoes. Orange-fleshed sweet potatoes are one of the richest natural sources of beta-carotene, a plant-based compound that is converted to vitamin A in your body. Vitamin A is critical to a healthy immune system, and low blood levels have been linked to reduced immunity. It's also a key for maintaining healthy mucous membranes, especially in the lining of your gut. The gut is where your body is exposed to many potential disease-causing pathogens. The antioxidants found in sweet potatoes benefit not only your immune system, but also your heart, teeth, and vision. Sweet potato recipes. Mashed sweet potato, bring a large pot of salted water to a boil. Add potatoes and cook until tender, 20 to 30 minutes. With an electric mixer on low, blend potatoes, slowly adding milk, about 1/2 cup at a time. Use more or less to achieve desired texture. Add butter and maple syrup to taste. Blend until smooth. Serve warm. Yummy. Baked sweet potato, roasting sweet potatoes in the oven brings out their natural flavor and sweetness. There is no need to add syrup or marshmallows to them, they are perfectly sweet on their own. If you're busy and working all day, I also love making them in the crock pot. While there aren't any severe health problems associated with sweet potatoes, they are high in vitamin A, which the body stores. When levels get too high, you may notice your skin and nails looking a little orange. This side effect should decrease if you cut down on sweet potato consumption. 5. Ginger. Ginger is antibacterial, so it helps support the immune system and it can help to prevent nausea and soothe an upset stomach. Ginger is also a natural blood thinner and contains a phenolic anti-inflammatory compound called gingerol that may be responsible for relaxing blood vessels. Upping your intake of antioxidant-rich foods and beverages like ginger shots may combat inflammation and keep your immune system healthy. Interestingly, many test tube and animal studies suggest that ginger can enhance immune response. What's more, ginger has powerful antiviral and antibacterial properties. Ginger recipes. Ginger lime fruit salad, just a little lime and ginger help to macerate the fresh fruits so they can release their juices. Grapes, diced nectarines, or blackberries would also be delicious. Tea with ginger citrus ice cubes, infuse a warm cup of Earl Grey with the flavors of lemon and ginger with these innovative ice cubes. Frozen together, along with throat-soothing honey, the ice cubes bring a world of flavor and take a normal cup of tea from basic to impressive. In small doses, ginger has few side effects. High doses of ginger, more than 5 grams a day, increases the chances of side effects. Ginger on the skin may cause a rash. Consumption may cause gas, heartburn, upset stomach, mouth irritation. What is more, ginger may raise the risk of bleeding. If you have a bleeding disorder, it may not be safe. 6. Green tea. Whether you prefer green or black tea, your immune system is in luck. Both provide disease-fighting antioxidants, polyphenols, and flavonoids that protect against free radicals and help destroy them. One study showed that catechins, a particular type of polyphenols in tea, kill certain viruses. Regularly drinking green tea can help you lose weight and reduce your risk of several diseases, including diabetes, heart disease, and cancer. Drinking 3 to 5 cups of green tea per day seems to be optimal to reap the most health benefits. Green tea idea. Iced green tea with lemon, lime, and fresh mint is a refreshing and revitalizing beverage for those warm days. Each glass is naturally sweetened with honey and packed with antioxidants. A cold glass of iced green tea instantly quenches your thirst on those blazing hot days. What is even better is adding some freshly squeezed citrus juices to the drink, giving you the ultimate flavor combination. Lemons are known to make your mouth pucker. To better balance the tartness, lime juice is blended into the mix for a softer sourness. Green tea is good for you, but only if drunk in moderation. While the polyphenols in green tea are credited with preventing heart disease and cancer, it seems they can cause liver and kidney damage if consumed in very large quantities, a review of studies into the toxicity of polyphenols has shown. 7. Almonds. Unsalted almonds are one of the best things to keep around the house for a quick immune-boosting snack. Almonds are high in vitamin E that acts as an antioxidant in your body and helps immune system function. Almonds also contain iron and protein that are essential for your immune system. Almonds are easy to find in any grocery store. They're perfect as a healthy snack and can be added to salads and yogurt. Fresh almonds are high in vitamin E that helps immune system function. Though almonds have been proven as effective in curing spasms and pain, if you consume them in excess, it can lead to toxicity in your body. This is because they contain hydrocyanic acid, an overconsumption of which can lead to breathing problem and nervous breakdown. Eating 8 to 10 soaked almonds in a day goes a long way in adding valuable nutrients to your daily diet. 8. Orange. These fruits are rich in vitamin C, which is essential for boosting your immune system and fighting off colds and infections. Vitamin C has the added benefit of contributing to normal collagen formation, which helps promote healthy glowing skin. How many do I need to eat? One orange a day will give you 93% of all the vitamin C you need. Orange cheesecake breakfast rolls. These yummy rolls are a nice change of pace from the typical brown sugar and cinnamon kind. They make a nice treat for breakfast or brunch. Orange ricotta pancakes. These popular pancakes are likely to spark a craving. For a different twist, switch the citrus ingredient to lime or lemon juice. Potential downsides of orange juice. Regular consumption has been associated with several health benefits, including improved heart health, decreased inflammation, and a reduced risk of kidney stones. However, it's also high in calories and sugar, so it's best to consume it in moderation and select fresh squeezed or 100% orange juice whenever possible. Several studies have found that regularly drinking sugar-sweetened beverages, such as fruit juice, may be linked to a higher risk of type 2 diabetes. 9. Oysters. Oysters. They've got zinc in them, which appears to have some virus-fighting powers. That's probably because zinc helps create and activate white blood cells involved in the immune response. Zinc is important for immune function and wound healing, and oysters contain more zinc per serving than any other food. Eat just 2 oysters, and you'll meet the government's recommended daily intake for zinc. It also assists your immune system with tasks such as healing wounds. Oysters also have a bit of vitamin A. Try oyster stew for dinner or have raw oysters as an appetizer. You'll find canned or fresh raw oysters in most grocery stores. Oyster recipes. Garlic oysters were one of the most popular appetizers on my restaurant menu years ago at the Jersey Shore. You may not find these on many menus, but this restaurant classic is sure to be a welcome addition to your dinner table for the holidays and beyond. Classic oyster stew. There are countless versions of this simple, elegant stew. To achieve the perfect texture of just cooked oysters, poach them in the milk until their edges begin to curl, set aside, and return them to the stew just before serving. The illnesses of most concern from eating raw or undercooked oysters or clams are Vibrio infection, norovirus infection, and hepatitis A. Symptoms can include vomiting, diarrhea, nausea, stomach pains, severe weakness. 10. Watermelon. Watermelon is an immune-boosting fruit. 1 2-cup serving of watermelon has 270 milligrams of potassium, 30% of the daily value of vitamin A, and 25% of the value of vitamin C. Calories in watermelon aren't much at all. 1 2-cup serving of watermelon has just 80 calories. Watermelon also provides vitamin B6 and glutathione. The body needs these vitamins, nutrients, and compounds like glutathione for proper immune function. But what makes it a superfood is its large concentration of lycopene. Lycopene gives watermelon flesh its red color and offers an array of health-building benefits, including reducing respiratory inflammation, which helps prevent infection. If possible, make watermelon part of your healthy diet year-round. Watermelon recipes. Watermelon and feta orzo salad. Watermelon and feta make a foolproof salad combo, but orzo, arugula, and a homemade lemony vinaigrette take this dish to delicious new heights. Tomato and watermelon salad. This no-cook salad combines sweet, juicy watermelon chunks with the makings of a beautiful summer salad. Watermelon gazpacho. Cool off with your new favorite chilled soup. Every summer should see a batch of watermelon gazpacho. Here are some side effects of eating watermelon in large quantity. May cause diarrhea and other digestive problems. May up glucose levels. May increase the risk of developing liver inflammation. May cause overhydration or water intoxication. May cause cardiovascular problems. 11. Low-fat yogurt. Low-fat yogurt can have an immune-boosting effect because yogurt contains live and active cultures or probiotics that may help stimulate the immune system and fight off disease. While more research needs to be done, there's some evidence that some strains of probiotics can help boost the immune system and promote a healthy digestive tract. Make sure that the yogurt you buy does indeed contain probiotics by looking on the label for the bacterial strains it contains. Blueberry yogurt, we all know plain yogurt is good, however, sometimes adding the simplest thing to it can transform it to extraordinarily good. I started with Phi-A-Total 5% plain Greek yogurt and instead of just tossing on a handful of blueberries or chopped fruit, I took an extra few minutes and threw blueberries into a pan. To that, I added a tablespoon of water and just a pinch of sugar. Minutes later I had beautiful, healthy and delicious blueberry compote for my creamy Phi-A yogurt. However, the majority of yogurt available in the grocery store is flavored, which means full of sugar and or artificial sweeteners. These additives feed the bad bacteria in the gut, which basically negates the benefits of the probiotics. That's why we should always look for low-fat and low-sugar yogurt. Besides, yogurt may have adverse effects for those with lactose intolerance or milk allergies. 12. Dark chocolate. Believe it or not, dark chocolate helps boost our immune system. The cacao found in dark chocolate and the phenolic compounds inside the cocoa can strengthen the defenses of our immune system and up our body's resistance. Unsweetened dark chocolate is pretty bitter, but eating it will help you bounce back from your cold faster. Besides, many studies in the past have shown that dark chocolate is a bit of a superfood. It can help improve blood flow as well as brain function, and has antioxidants, among other benefits. Dark chocolate almond bars. Melt cacao butter in a double boiler or in a glass mixing bowl set over a small saucepan with 1 inch of water over medium heat. Once melted, remove from heat and add maple syrup and whisk to combine. When the mixture is completely fluid with no separation, add cacao or cocoa powder and vanilla extract. Whisk to thoroughly combine. Taste and adjust sweetness if needed, I found 1/3 cup to be perfect. Pour the chocolate into candy molds, if you have them, mini paper cupcake liners, or simply line a baking sheet with parchment paper and pour the chocolate on top. Top with roasted almonds and sprinkle of salt. Set in the refrigerator or freezer to harden for 30 minutes to 1 hour. Once completely solid, break or cut into pieces, bars. These can be kept at room temperature for serving. But for best freshness, store chocolate in an airtight container or freezer bag in the refrigerator for 2 to 3 weeks, or the freezer for 1 to 2 months. The recommended dose is approximately 1 to 2 ounces or 30 to 60 grams, experts say. Indulge in anything more than that, and you may be consuming too many calories. A 1.45 ounce 41 gram dark chocolate bar has 190 calories. 13. Turmeric. Turmeric has been deemed the superfood spice of choice for busting pain and inflammation for centuries now, but there is much more to this magical spice than just its amazing anti-inflammatory properties. Here is a spice that should be added to your cold and flu prevention regimen. Turmeric is a natural way to help bolster the immune system by increasing the immunomodulating capacity of the body. Try adding extra turmeric into your diet during periods of stress or during flu season to help give your immune system a little boost. Creamy turmeric chicken skillet. This creamy one skillet chicken dinner gets a double dose of vibrant turmeric and is finished with a lush sauce. Turmeric fried eggs with kale, yogurt, and bacon. Breakfast bowls shouldn't take 2 hours to make, this one is ready in about 20 minutes. Overnight oats with cashews, seeds, and turmeric. This sizzled seed and cashew mixture is delicious sprinkled over dip and soups, so you might want to make extra. Turmeric usually does not cause significant side effects, however, some people can experience stomach upset, nausea, dizziness, or diarrhea. In one report, a person who took very high amounts of turmeric, over 1,500 milligrams twice daily, experienced a dangerous abnormal heart rhythm. 14. Oily fish. Another food group that is great for your immune system is fish, particularly more oily fish like tuna, mackerel and salmon. These fish are a great source of healthy fats for your body, in particular omega-3, which the body can't produce on its own. Fish is a great source of zinc, which our bodies are unable to make naturally, so it's important that you find ways of consuming it. Zinc helps your immune system in repairing damaged cells, so try to include fish in your diet on a weekly basis. But eating too much oily fish can actually increase the risk of developing type 2 diabetes by up to a quarter, a study has found. While experts recommend eating up to 4 portions of oily fish such as mackerel and salmon a week, those who eat more than that could be doing themselves harm. 15. Spinach. Spinach is immune-boosting foods that contain high levels of vitamin C, which not only packs a powerful antioxidant punch, it helps fight off infection and regenerate other antioxidants in the body, including vitamin E. They also contain folate, another immune booster. Spinach is a healthy and nutrient-rich food you should certainly include in your everyday diet. You may hate spinach, but it is a wonderful source of iron, folate, chlorophyll, vitamin E, magnesium, vitamin A, fiber, plant protein, and vitamin C. By eating spinach, you're just cleaning your skin from the inside out. Lentil salad with beets and spinach, pre-cooked lentils make this healthy lunch come together in 10 minutes, or less. You can also roast the beets ahead of time, look for the golden variety in grocery stores. They're much less messy than red beets, which can stain your hands and your cutting board. Creamed curried spinach, curry powder adds warmth and earthiness to this speedy version of creamed spinach. Whole milk yogurt gives the side a luscious mouth feel and plenty of body. Serve with steak or with seared planks of spice-rubbed tofu. Yet, consume too much and you may be in for unpleasant symptoms such as kidney stones, abdominal pain, low blood pressure, tremors or convulsions, vomiting, and weak pulse. But don't think this means dark, leafy greens aren't part of a healthy diet. In moderation, they're perfectly fine. 16. Sunflower seeds. Sunflower seeds contain selenium, which help your body fight against certain cancers, while also helping your immune system to control cell damage. A variety of studies, mostly performed on animals, have looked at the potential of selenium to combat viral infections such as H1N1. Sunflower seeds are a great source of vitamin E, which helps maintain healthy skin, hair, and nails. You can eat sunflower seeds raw or buy dry roasted seeds with or without the shell. They also come in flavored varieties. To eat a sunflower seed, run your tongue along the salty outer shell, crack it between your teeth, and spit out the shell before chewing the seed. Though allergies to sunflower seeds are relatively uncommon, some cases have been reported. Reactions may include asthma, mouth swelling, itching of the mouth, hay fever, skin rashes, lesions, vomiting, and anaphylaxis. Too much salt in your diet is tough on your heart and kidneys. It may also cause you to retain water and lead to high blood pressure. 17. Chicken soup. Chicken soup contains vitamins A and C, magnesium, phosphorus, gelatin, and antioxidants, which are known to build a strong immune system and fight off viruses. The protein from chicken provides amino acids that are used to build antibodies to fight infection. Chicken soup appears to help fight colds, according to several studies. It helps clear nasal congestion as well as thin mucus so you can better cough it up. In addition, research shows it may have a mild anti-inflammatory effect that can help ease symptoms. Chicken noodle soup is one of the easiest soups to make. The ingredients are simple and inexpensive. You are looking at about 40 minutes from start to finish for this soup. Not too bad, especially when 20 minutes of that time is hands-off. Chicken soup is better when made with darker meat. Chicken thighs become tender and soft in the soup. Chicken breast doesn't tenderize and stays firm in the soup. You can use both cuts of chicken, but thighs will produce better soup. As for the noodles, you can use whatever you love. We love the lightness of egg noodles, but you can throw just about any pasta into the pot. Why chicken noodle soup often isn't as healthy as you may think. Misleading labels, high amounts of sodium, and unnecessary ingredients are just a few reasons to be choosier about which soup you eat. 18. Mushrooms. The mushrooms you might see on your supermarket shelves, cremini, shiitake, portobello, are not only harmless, but very healthy. Medicinal mushrooms have been used in Eastern medicine for thousands of years. Mushrooms are prebiotic, boosting the microbiome's beneficial bacteria, such as Acidophilus and Bifidobacterium, improving digestion and overall health. Recent independent research shows that certain varieties of mushroom are also our best dietary sources for potent antioxidants, such as sulfur-rich ergothioneine, and the major biological antioxidant, glutathione. A diet rich in antioxidants like ergothioneine and glutathione protects cells from free radicals, helping the body withstand normal oxidative stress that damages healthy cells. In addition to boosting longevity, mushrooms pack a serious nutritional punch, providing a great source of vitamin D, essential for strong immune system function. Garlic mushrooms. Melt in your mouth. Garlic mushrooms can be enjoyed at breakfast, as a side to roast chicken, pork roast with crackle or with a juicy steakhouse steak. They are so versatile, you can even stuff mushrooms inside chicken breasts. Or keep it simple and serve them on your toasts or garlic bread. Normally, garlic mushrooms are cooked in butter and garlic, hence the name of the recipe. However, you will love the extra ingredients we add even more. Because an extra kick of flavor never hurt anyone. Let's say you've decided to eat 10 cups of mushrooms in a day. You will easily exceed the daily recommendations for fiber, the B vitamins and vitamin D if you eat the kind exposed to ultraviolet light. After eating those 10 cups, you will have consumed up to 51 grams of fiber, up to 450% of the RDA for riboflavin, 630% of the RDA for niacin, 700% of your daily pantothenic acid needs and 520% of your daily B6. You might feel the effects of too much fiber, gas, bloating, constipation and stomach pain, but nothing that would make you seriously ill. The same applies for the B vitamins, mostly. B vitamins are water-soluble, which means they're not stored in your body, and any excess is excreted in your urine. 19. Egg. Adequate protein intake is important to support immune response, and eggs are a great way to do this since they also contain nutrients like vitamin D, zinc, selenium, and vitamin E that the body needs for proper immune functioning. Breakfast burrito, meal prep has never been easier than with this tasty and filling breakfast burrito. After making these 6 egg filling, you can enjoy these wraps all week. Egg and cheese sandwiches, save yourself the day of hassle and prep these easy, microwavable sammies instead. Sweet potato and kale frittata, everything's better with sweet potatoes, especially this garlicky frittata. The science is clear that up to 3 whole eggs per day are perfectly safe for healthy people. Eggs are a source of saturated fat, and too much saturated fat has been shown to raise total cholesterol and LDL, bad cholesterol levels, risk factors for cardiovascular disease. 20. Apple. Apples are great sources of fiber and natural sugars, but you knew that already. What you might not know is that apple skins contain quercetin, a type of plant pigment flavonoid that helps boost your immune system and reduce inflammation. Antioxidant-rich apples may help protect your lungs from oxidative damage. An apple a day really can keep the doctor away. Homemade apple cider, when life gives you apples, make apple cider. Apple dump cake, key to staying warm. Apple galette, all the flavor of your fav pie, but way easier to whip up. Apple tart, an apple tart worthy of your Thanksgiving table. Apple pie, a homemade apple pie that will even impress your grandma. Eating apples in excess will not cause many side effects. But as with anything eaten in excess, apples may contribute to weight gain. Furthermore, apples are acidic, and the juice may damage tooth enamel. Apples are high in fructose, a type of sugar. Fructose can only be absorbed in the liver, and when it's there, it produces harmful fats called triglycerides, which can lead to heart disease. Eating too many apples can lead to excess fructose in the body, which can contribute to diabetes and obesity as well. What is your favorite food to boost immunity? What is your secret recipe? Please comment down below. See you in the next video.